Hey guys, welcome back. So now we're talking about food hygiene, which is the basic fundamental things that you need to know before you get yourself into the kitchen operation. So please bear in mind that this slide is actually adapted from Ministry of Health slides for food handlers training, because I found that this slide is very relevant for you, for those people who are the beginners who try to understand on the food hygiene, the basic understanding of food hygiene. So you guys will be with me until the end of the lecture and you will gain something. So remember that food handlers are being governed with legislative power just like the rest, just as the other industry, which is we are be governed by Food Act 1983, Food Regulations 1985, Food Hygiene Regulation 2009, and Control of Infectious Diseases Act 1988. So all this legislative power is according to what are the things that it governs. For example, Food Act, if you want to know about the definition of certain foods, what are the offense, what are the things that you should follow, the restriction in terms of the ingredients. So something like this that you can always find it. If you want to get to know more about it, you can always get a copy in the nearest bookstore, or you can Google it to get the content of it. Alright, so today we will talk about the importance of food hygiene and safety, because in the end, the reason why we want to give this exposure is to avoid from food poisoning to be happen in Malaysia, in our country. Yeah, remember that the food poisoning can be different from one to another. The people can be harmed from food poisoning can be differentiate from the type of the bacteria goes into the body, and then the immune system itself for the people, the victim, and also the how much of the bacteria goes in the body. So these are the things that actually can be different from one another. That's the reason why some people will get certain symptoms, while certain people will get another symptom. So you will get the symptoms that related to the food hygiene. Usually you will have a cramp in your stomach, you will have nauseous, you vomit, you have a fever, and then you have a diarrhea which related to the food poisoning. And due to the diarrhea, which it will drain out the fluid inside the body, and definitely your body cannot function well, especially all the organs, internal organs, which can lead to death. So that is the reason. This is very serious. So that is the reason why we want every each of food handlers need to have the basic understanding to avoid this thing from happen. So if you look at this picture, yeah, you know, always we've been served with very delicious food. It looks delicious, but it doesn't mean that it's safe. So it is responsible. It is your responsible as a food handler to make sure that the food, it looks good, it looks delicious, but it is safe to consume. As you can see here, there is a flies inside it, which is can be one of the main reasons that contaminate the food and can lead to the food poisoning. So as a personal health, please, for all the food handlers, if you decide to be in the food industry, you need to have a health check. Check your health. Alright, and then you get the anti-typhoid vaccination, which is compulsory for those people, for those food handlers in Malaysia. If you have if you're feeling ill, you need to seek treatment. Do not work if you feel ill, especially if you have a flu, runny nose, because it's that diarrhea, because it's definitely will sometimes some of when we get sick, we tend to forget to take care of personal cleanliness, and that is the reason why you need to seek treatment first before you to make sure that you fit into the kitchen. So if you get wound, you get cut, always use waterproof plaster. Do not just expose it and then you fall and just strip away doing your job. Because the potential for you to transmit your blood into the food is very high. So please just get a plaster, waterproof plaster, waterproof plastic possible to cover your wound. And for food handlers, make sure whatever if you have if you are operating from your house or you are have your own shop or station, you need to take a bath, take a shower before you get into yourself in the operation. And please have a short and clean fingernails, which is very very basic things that you as a food handler can do. All right, do not wear jewelry because it can bring all the bacteria together, all right, with you, and then it will transmit to your hand, and then your hand will go into the food. So these are things that the reason why we are not allowed, we're not recommended to wear jewelry. And some of the cases, this jewelry, I mean, is dropped into the food, which is definitely a big no, in a food when you are serving to people and you can see some physical things which is not edible inside your food. So long and vanish fingernails also are not allowed in a cage operation. If you look at this picture, it looks very clean. So these are things that we hope that all the food handlers will look clean and clean as well. It's just not look clean, but it is they are clean. And then they look very inviting. Yeah, make sure you cover your head, wear caps to make sure that you will not drop your hair into the food. Clean clothing, please change every day, and then wear an apron, possibly to get two aprons. One today you wear this one apron, and tomorrow you wash another one, and you can get a fresh one, another fresh apron to use it. So you can continue and rotate your aprons. Do not wear one apron for one whole week, which definitely can always bring to the food, can lead to the food poisoning because your hands always touch the apron. So always wear footwear because this is for your safety, and also is for because we might it, you might slip if you are not wearing the right footwear. And always wear a glove because your hands is a medium to bring the pathogens to the food, so you need to always wash it thoroughly in a good correct way. And if you are handling food that which is ready to eat but raw, you need to use glove. So offenses, if you look at this picture, you can see that these food handlers look dirty, and also you can see all the offenses such as runny nose, smoking, not wearing the footwear, right footwear, and then you name it. It's not wearing head cover, smoking, improper wearing of head cover. So these are the things that always the food handlers out there doing. So you, after this lecture, I hope that all of you can avoid this thing from happen. And bad food handling practices such as tasting by dipping finger into the food is a big no. You can always use two spoons and you can taste the food. Do not dip your finger. It's just way bad behavior that need to be avoided, you as a food handlers. For those people, for those food handlers who are smoking, you can always smoke somewhere which is away from the kitchen operation. Alright, and please make sure that you wash your hands after you smoke. And the best way is to quit smoking because it's not good for your health. And then it's very natural. Sometimes we scratch our head, we scratch our body. So that is the reason why we need to wash our hands regularly before we touch foods. Yeah. So it's a bad food habit, a bad habit, but you need to wash it. You know. If you know that it's a bad habit, you have to know how to control it. You do not touch food with bare hands. It's a big no. What and clear nostril is something that really disgusting. So you need to avoid to do it. And coughing over food also something that the bad habit that always been seen among food handlers. So guys, these are the things that you need to make sure that you're not doing it. During the food operation, the good food handling practice is always wearing gloves because if your hands is not dirty, if you're wearing gloves, you can always acceptable. Now make sure that one activity and one glove. It means you have one activity such as you are mixing all the salads and then you throw away and make sure, because it's disposable, throw it away and get a new fresh one for the next activities. And wash utensils on all the crockeries in the sink. Do not wash it in the toilet or on the floor, all right? And using tongs to take food, and then please wash hands. So washing hands, it should be in the correct way. So there are 7 steps of the proper washing of hands. The first one, wash hands with sufficient amount of soap, and then you scrub the palms until become soapy, and scrub each finger and between fingers, and then use fingernails to scrub your palms, okay? And then scrub the back of the hands, and then you rinse hands completely under warm running water, and dry hands with a clean towel of tissue. So make sure if you are following this 7 step of proper washing hands, inshallah things are getting your food handling will be in the right track. So equipment which is clean and good condition is a must. So make sure that you are back to your kitchen. Please have the kind of audit every single things, equipment, your tools, to make sure they are fit to be used in operation. Do not use the inappropriate utensils just like this. Yeah, it's a broken wooden utensil. It's a big no. It's try to get stainless steel even for the kit, for the knife. Or for the wooden, for cutting board, get a rubber or plastic cutting board, and then this rusty something like this, you should be discarded. And then make sure that the use of utensil needs to be separated. Do not, if you are mixing one cutting board with all the ingredients, definitely it will lead to food poisoning. All right, because we never know, and try to control it by having different colors or different type, more than one cutting boards, and please make it separate to avoid cross contamination. So step in washing utensils, you throw the waste, wash it, rinse it, sanitize it, and you dry it, and make sure that your shop or your station should have the grease trap to trap all the grease and to avoid that it getting clogged in the pipeline, and then it will attract all the to pass, which is definitely will affect your operation if the pass is around. So washing practices, please wash at the proper place in the sink. If you don't have a very small, if you have a very small place, you can always wear. You are allowed to do it at the back, but please at the higher position. Get some tables and then wash it at the back. Do not wash on the floor. It's a big no, because you can always contaminate all the crockeries from this floor, because the floor is somewhere all the dirty things, because people step on it, and then all the pests are crawling on the floor. So this is a thing that we are trying to avoid, because cockeries have to be clean. It should be somewhere that is supposed to be, not on the floor. Your premises should be clean. The ceiling, wall, floor. So audit your place. Make sure that everything is clean and nice. So dirty premises that you can see here. This is the raw pictures which has been taken. Based on the true events. All right. You can see it's very. So gross, alright. This is how far a food handler can do. So please, after this, take a look on your operation. Take care of your place to make sure that it's always clean. Basic facilities such as a toilet should be clean. Make sure the drainage system is on tip top, and clean washing basin is available for use. And for those people who have a roadside premises, make sure that you always cover your food. Do not expose it, because you know being at the roadside premises is exposed to the dust and all. So these are things that you need to know, that make sure that you prevent it by covering all the foods that you are serving. So no pests, get a pest control. If your place have these pests as cockroaches, mice, and then the flies. So get the pest control and manage it well. Try to avoid, because these are the one of the factors lead to the food poisoning. So outside premises also is your responsible to make sure that drainage system is on, is clean, and function. All right, for disposal for refuse, you can always put it inside the plastic, and then you throw it in the bin. So it's easier for to be clean afterwards by the local contractor who responsible to clean, to take out all the garbages. Alright, the incorrect disposal of refuse is just, as you can see here, is very inappropriate, which is the dustbin is here but it is exposed. So please do not do like this. And I hope the topic, what we conclude here, is you to understand that food hygiene start from you, alright, and the environment. So be sensitive to personal hygiene, the equipment used, and the state of premises. You need to audit your place yourself as a food handler, and you need to get proper clothing that should be worn during food handling. It should be something clean, and it looks clean and clean as well. Carry out your good practices when handling food, and I hope you get something throughout this lecture, and I hope that you can make some difference in handling food. And in the end, all we want to do is to avoid the food poisoning to be happen. Thank you so much.